everyone, welcome back to my channel. In this video, we are going to discuss about Anglo-Saxon Age. Like what is Anglo-Saxon Age in English literature, historical context of this age, then themes of Anglo-Saxon literature, and at last, key features of Anglo-Saxon literature. So friends, if you haven't yet subscribed to my channel, then do subscribe to it and hit the bell icon so that you can get every notifications of my upcoming videos. Now without doing further delay, let's jump to the topic. The Anglo-Saxon Age or the Old English period refers to a time in English history from the 5th to the 11th century, means from the 5th century to the Norman conquest in 1066 AD, means about 450 AD से 1066 तक के time period को English history में Anglo-Saxon Age कहा जाता है. Okay, and it is the earliest recorded period of English literature and culture. And at the same time, it is also an important period in the development of English literature. The Anglo-Saxon Age began with the arrival of Germanic tribes like the Angles, Saxons and Jutes, who migrated to England from present-day Germany and Denmark after the fall of the Roman Empire. They established their kingdoms and brought with them their language, Old English, which evolved into Middle English and eventually Modern English. Simple words में समझे तो जब कुछ Germanic tribes जैसे कि Saxons, Angles and Jutes ये जब Roman Empire के fall के बाद England में रहने आए थे, वहीं से Anglo-Saxon Age start होता है और ये 1066 यानी कि 1066 में Anglo-Norman conquest के साथ एंड हो जाता है. मींस 450 से लेकर के 1066 तक के टाइम पीरियड को इंग्लिश हिस्ट्री में Anglo-Saxon Age कहा जाता है. नाउ लेट्स लुक एट द हिस्टोरिकल कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ दिस पीरियड. सो बिफोर 55 BC द लैंड ऑफ ब्रिटेन वॉज इनहैबिटेड बाई सेल्ट्स. दे वर ओरिजिनल इनहैबिटेंट्स ऑफ ब्रिटेन. सेल्ट्स वर कॉल्ड ब्राइथॉन्स आर ब्राइटॉन्स एंड दैट इज हाउ वी गॉट द नेम ब्रिटेन. नाउ सेल्ट्स continued to live there till Roman conquest in 55 BC. So 55 BC के पहले जो लोग ब्रिटेन में रह रहे थे वे लोग सेल्ट्स कहे जाते थे. इसके बाद जो लोग आए वो रोमन थे. In 55 BC, Roman invaded Britain and they continued to live there till 410 AD. तो 55 BC से 410 AD को रोमन ब्रिटेन कहा जाता है बिकॉज इस टाइम तक जो लोग इंग्लैंड में रह रहे थे वे लोग रोमन थे. Now let's see how the Romans invaded Britain. It was Julius Caesar who launched the first Roman invasion of Britain but made no permanent conquest. In 43 AD, the Roman Emperor Claudius successfully invaded Britain, establishing Roman rule and founding the province of Britannia. Now the Roman influence brought advancements in urbanization, infrastructure and culture, such as the construction of roads, towns and villas, and made London an important trading center. Over time, Roman control gradually declined, and by the early 5th century, Roman forces withdrew from Britain. Then came the Anglo-Saxon. Following the Roman departure, Germanic tribes or the invaders, Angles, Saxons, and Jutes came from their homeland, Germany. They migrated to Britain from regions including modern-day Germany and Denmark. So the Anglo-Saxon invasion of Britain occurred during the 5th and 6th centuries. The Angles, Saxons and Jutes were Germanic tribes from what is now Germany and Denmark. They migrated to Britain and gradually established their own kingdoms. Displacing the Romano-British population, they get settled in different parts of Britain. The exact dates and details of the invasion are not well documented, and much of what we know comes from later historical accounts and archaeological evidence. The Angles settled in a region that are now known as East Anglia, Mercia and Northumbria. The Saxons established their kingdoms in areas that are now known as Wessex and Sussex. The Jutes settled in Kent. The Angles settled along the eastern coast and being the most numerous, gave their name to the whole country, Angle Land or England. So this is how we got the name England. These tribes gradually expanded their territories and established several small kingdoms across Britain. They brought with them their own language, Old English. The Anglo-Saxon invasion had a profound impact on the culture, linguistic and political landscape of Britain. It marked the end of Roman rule in Britain and the beginning of the Anglo-Saxon period, which lasted for several centuries until the Norman conquest in 1066 AD. Now let's talk about the themes of Anglo-Saxon literature. The themes in Anglo-Saxon literature often revolve around heroic ideals, such as bravery, loyalty, and honor. The characters are usually warriors and kings who face great challenges and display heroic qualities. If you look at the literature of the Anglo-Saxon age, then you will find that the literature of this period primarily consists of epic poems, heroic tales, and religious writings. So all the works written in that age were dealing with heroism or religious topic. One of the most famous works from this period is the epic poem Beowulf. It tells the story of a brave warrior named Beowulf who battles monsters like Grendel and defends his kingdom. Another notable literary works from this time is The Dream of the Rood. It is a religious poem that describes the crucifixion of Jesus Christ from the perspective of the cross. It reflects the strong influence of Christianity during the Anglo-Saxon period. Now let's discuss the key features of Anglo-Saxon literature. So first one is oral tradition. During this period, the primary mode of communication was oral. Poetry and prose were recited and sung by poets were called scops or bards. These works were passed down from generation to generation through oral tradition. So most of the literature from this era was orally transmitted, meaning it was passed down through generation by word of mouth. Second is heroic values. Anglo-Saxon literature often celebrated heroic ideals and virtues such as bravery, loyalty, honor, and the pursuit of glory. The most famous example of this period is the epic poem Beowulf, which narrates the exploits of a heroic warrior who battles monsters and defends his people. Third is Christian influence. The Anglo-Saxon age saw the gradual conversion of the Anglo-Saxons to Christianity. Christian themes and elements were integrated into their language, blending with the existing pagan traditions. The most notable example of this synthesis is the poem The Dream of the Rood, which combines Christian and heroic elements. Fourth is canons and alliteration. Anglo-Saxon poetry relied heavily on poetic devices like canons and alliteration. Canons are compound expressions used to describe an object or person indirectly, often using metaphors. Alliteration, whereas the repetition of consonant sounds, was used to create rhythm and enhance the oral quality of the verse. The Anglo-Saxon age came to the end with the Norman conquest of England in 1066. The Normans, who spoke a different language, Norman French, brought with their own literary tradition, which eventually merged with Old English to form Middle English. Overall, the Anglo-Saxon age represents a formative period in English literature, laying the foundation for later literary traditions in England. It reflects the cultural, historical, and linguistic development of the English people during this early medieval period. The literature of this period reflects the values, beliefs, and cultural identity of the Anglo-Saxons, while offering a glimpse into their historical and social context. Thank you for watching this video.